All praise be to Allah and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A believer went to an atheist barber to cut his hair. While the barber was cutting his hair, they started to talk about God. So the atheist barber said, "I don't think that this universe has a creator and that God exists." And continued saying, "You only have to go out into the street and you will immediately know that God doesn't exist. Look at the diseases and tragedies that people suffer in this community. Look at the homeless children in the streets. If God existed, he would not allow all these tragedies to happen. And I cannot love a God who allows all of this pain to occur." Then the believer replied to him saying, "O brother, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, 'وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ.' Call upon me, I will respond to you." And the conversation almost ended at this point. Then after the atheist barber finished his job, the believer left the barber shop and saw a homeless man with long disheveled hair on the street. He returned to the barber and said to him, "I don't think that a barber exists." The barber answered and said, "What's wrong with you, man? I'm a barber standing in front of you." And the man said, "If there was a barber, he wouldn't have left this homeless man with his long dirty hair." So the barber said, "But this man didn't come to me to shave." So the man said, "This is the point. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exists and he awaits us all. But the problem is that people don't go to him or ask him. So you see all these calamities and diseases among the people. However, if we accept Allah's destiny and turn to him with sincere hearts, then we will neither suffer nor struggle." After this symbolic story, we understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is near, accepts the supplication of his slaves, and all that we need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with sincere hearts. And we see that those who turn their back to the truth are the ones who suffer in life and afterlife. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, "فَمَنِ اتَّبَعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا يَضِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "And if there should come to you guidance from me, then whoever follows my guidance will neither go astray in the world nor suffer in the hereafter. And whoever turns away from my remembrance, indeed he will have a depressed life. And we will gather him on the day of resurrection blind. He will say, 'My Lord, why have you raised me blind while I was once seeing?' Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, 'Thus did our signs come to you, and you forgot them, and thus will you this day be forgotten. And thus do we recompense he who transgressed and didn't believe in the signs of his Lord, and the punishment of the hereafter is more severe and more enduring.'" Yes, they suffer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about those who don't believe or turn their back to Allah's remembrance with the disobedience will suffer from ma'ishatan danka, means a depressing life that you can't get rid of it. But those who believe and obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never get this depressed life, because if they found any difficulties or calamities, they would say, "I have a Lord who will take care of me and take me out of this, and he will get me a way out of any problem." For those who don't believe, they will feel depressed and even attempt suicide. Unlike the believer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Those who have believed and whose hearts are assured by the remembrance of Allah, unquestionably by the remembrance of Allah, hearts are assured." Here is a thought experiment. If all you have is only $1 and you lose it, would you be happy or sad? But what if you have another $10 at home? Would you still be sad? What if you had 1,000? Now consider, what if you have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with you? Anything you lose, you will never care, because you will say, "I have a Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with me and he will take care of me." Prophet Musa, peace be upon him, and his people, when they ran away from Egypt and Pharaoh was about to arrest them, then they said to Musa, peace be upon him, "Inna lamudrakun," indeed we are to be overtaken. The sea is behind us and Pharaoh is there and about to arrest or kill us. We can't escape. Here you will see strong faith. Here you will see the trust of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here you will see the real reliance upon the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prophet Musa, peace be upon him, said, Kalla, inna ma'ya rabbi sayahdeen. No, indeed, with me is my Lord. He will guide me. Allah will protect me and take care of me. I have Rabb. I have a Lord. Life is a test from Allah. Everyone will find a test or tribulation. However, the true believer will never suffer from sadness or depression. He will say with a satisfied heart, I have a Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. And we will surely test you with something of fear and hunger and a loss of wealth and lives and fruits. But give good tidings to the patient. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, If any servant of Allah who suffers a calamity says, We belong to Allah and to Him shall we return. O Allah, reward me for my affliction and give me something better than in exchange for it. Allah will give him reward for affliction and would give him something better than it in exchange. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the high rewards. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.